What's up guys, Ryan here, and today I'm going to show you how to change the color of the sky in your videos. I've been using this effect a lot as I've been editing my 2017 drone video. Haven't released it yet, a lot of drone shots that I haven't shown before. It's pretty awesome, coming out in like a week or two. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss it. Anyways, let's go into the tutorial and I'll show you how I did this. So I have this shot here of me at the sand dunes. Wish it was Dubai or something, but it's actually in Idaho, believe it or not. Anyways, the color of the sky is this blue color, and you know, it looks good, it's nothing horrible, but I want it to look like it's sunset, make it look a little more epic. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the effects tab, and I'm going to type in lumetri color. I'm going to drag that onto the clip, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a mask for that lumetri color. What that's going to do is it's going to make so that the lumetri color doesn't affect the whole clip. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a mask of the sky. It doesn't have to be exact, just something pretty close. And then on the edges, make sure you go out far because we're going to be feathering this mask. Now we're going to go over to the basic corrections and we're going to start playing around with the color. I like to use the temperature, tint, and exposure tools. So we're going to turn up the temperature. It's going to give it that orange look. And that's looking pretty good. And then we're going to go play around with the tint, give it a little pink color there, make it look like it's sunset. As you can see, the mask isn't very sharp. You know, it has that lines there, it doesn't look natural. So what we're going to do to fix that is we're going to go over to the feather tool right here. And we're going to turn it up. Maybe we'll go up to around 130, see how that looks. Okay, so it looks pretty good. You can still see there's a little bit of difference in color on the horizon, so maybe we'll change it to above 200, 238. So that's what it looks like with it, and that's what it looks like without it. Now let's play the clip, see what it looks like. Let's just say you have a clip where the sky isn't as stable as this drone shot. What I mean is the camera's moving, so that mask isn't going to stay in the same place. We're going to go over how to handle that situation. So I had this shot of my brother running in the sky. You know, it's very contrasted. I'm not a huge fan of that. So I want to change it to, once again, kind of a sunrise color. So I'm going to drag in the lumetri color. And then once again, we're going to draw a rough mask of the scenery here. Okay, so I'm just going by real quick, and this is at the end of the shot, okay? So once you get that done and you change the color up at the feather, what you're going to do is you're going to add a keyframe. So what a keyframe is going to do is it's going to lock that mask into place for that certain time. Now we're going to go towards the beginning of the clip, and you can see that the mask is still applied to the same region. It hasn't just stayed in the sky, it's down below now. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to about middle of the clip and we're going to select all the points. And the way you do that is you hold down the mouse and drag it, and this square is going to come up. It's going to select all the points, and then we're going to move it up for this particular motion. And then you're going to go through for each of all these, for all these points, and you're just going to move them accordingly to where they're supposed to be. You can look at the shape and where the points are. You can kind of tell where in the formation they should be. So you're going to do that, and then now we're going to go to the beginning. We're going to do the exact same thing. We're going to select all the points. We're going to drag up the points, and there we go. So as you can see, as I go through the clip, the keyframes are going to pretty much stay in the relatively the same place. If you want to be more exact, you can rotoscope it. So here's what the clip looks like with and without the change of sky color. I love this effect. It's very simple, but adds extra depth to your videos and doesn't take too long to do. Anyways, I'm going to be coming out with more tutorials soon, so make sure you hit that subscribe button, like this video. It's Ryan Shirley, and we'll see you later.